everyone. Thank you so much for joining me in this video. Welcome back, and if you are new here, welcome. My name is Quynh. I also go by QP, and on my channel, I make fashion, beauty, and lifestyle videos. So in this video, I wanted to share with you guys a haul I actually got for Black Friday. I know it's been a while since Black Friday, but shipping took a while, and it's been kind of a hectic few weeks after that. Anyway, I want to share with you guys all of these clothes on this rack right here. So in my last haul or last few hauls, I got a lot of fall items. One item that I didn't really keep or couldn't find the right ones for me were coats. And so I figured I would take advantage of all of the Black Friday sales and try to find some really cute coats that would last me years. So that's why we have the selection here. I also got a few more sweaters because I thought that I had a lot of sweaters to choose from, didn't really love all of them. So I wanted something less bulky this time around. So I got three from Banana Republic. And then I also got a few pairs of pants. I mostly just wanted to see how Banana Republic pants would fit me. I know that they actually have quite a selection of petite pants, and they also have short sizes. So I wanted to get some of their pants to see if they fit a little bit better than the brands I've shopped for in the past. All right, so anyway, let's go ahead and jump into this haul. I wanna talk about the first couple of items which I have on right now. So this one is the chunky cable knit sweater. This is an extra small petite. They actually have a lot of petite sizing for almost everything on their website, which is actually really, really nice. And it honestly fits really, really well. I think it's really nice because the sweater isn't super chunky. It's very comfortable. It's not itchy at all. Right now I have it tucked in. I thought that there was way too much material to tuck in, to be honest. And these pants are quite tight, but after having tucked these in, they actually look really good. And I think that's because this isn't very thick. For anyone who likes wearing their sweaters not tucked in, this is still a very nice length. So it is longer in the back than it is the front. Personally for me, I'm not a huge fan of that. I wish it was just kind of one length all the way around. I think that that just looks better, but that's also just my taste. If you like kind of having it a little bit longer in the back to cover up like a butt or anything like that, this is really nice for that. Mostly for me though, I'm probably gonna wear this tucked in. I also wanna talk about the material of this sweater. It is 57% cotton and 43% recycled polyester. It is machine washable, which I really like because it's less care, less maintenance. I don't have to dry clean it. I don't have to worry about it. So that's really nice. But this material, I think, is one of the more comfortable materials for sweaters that I've tried on recently. The arms actually go to like the perfect length for me. These normally go really long on me, and with a sweater material, it's a lot harder to alter and like tailor. But because this is petite sizing, it just fits me like perfectly. Okay, so let's move on to these pants. These are the high-rise Sloan leggings. They are actually very, very comfortable. I got them in the size 2 short, and they actually fit almost perfectly. I think if I were to wear flats or like any other type of shoes other than boots, this would be like the perfect length. However, with boots, it's like a little bit too long for boots, and these have a zipper at the very bottom, so you can't really roll them up, and it looks awkward if you try to roll these up. And again, with the zipper, one thing to note is it is a lot more difficult to alter or tailor to your height. So that's kind of something to consider as well. It's probably gonna cost more to tailor these pants if you end up getting them. With that said though, I really do like these pants. They are super, super comfortable. And even though they are leggings, they fit more like dress pants. They're very nice, very fitted, very flattering in my opinion. And then I like that it has this kind of stitching for all the way down. I don't know if that's the correct like name of it, but it just kind of has material and then it just stitches all the way down. So that to me gives like a really nice kind of like straight line effect, and you want that to kind of give height to the body. It has zippers on the side. The only thing I don't like about these pants is that it doesn't have pockets, and I am a pocket person. I love putting my hands in my pockets, but other than that, I think it's really, really comfortable, and it's a really cute pair of pants. And with this outfit, I actually paired it with this unlined double face top coat. That's what it's called on the website. It's a really nice dark camel color, which I think is beautiful, and it's very, very popular this season as well. This was one of the more expensive coats that I got in this haul. This was $150, I wanna say, original price, but with the discount, I think I got it around like $130. And I feel like for that price, it would have been nice if it was lined. I feel like that's kind of, you're getting more towards like the premium pricing once you hit that kind of like $150 price. However, it is very, very nice and it's light. So I feel like that's kind of one thing you're giving up. You're giving up the lining, but you're also getting a really light coat on top of it. This has a very straight fit. I know that loose, kind of more boyfriend fit coats are really in right now, and this totally has that look. It is not contoured to my body at all. This is not their petite sizing. This is just an extra small, but it honestly fits just fine. I don't think I need to go down to petite sizing for this. Where you can tell a difference though is with the sleeves, as you guys can see. They are a little bit long on me, but that's something that I could probably take up fairly easily. This hits me right at the knee, which I absolutely love. I think that is a phenomenal length on me. That's exactly where I would want a coat like this to hit. And I love that I don't have to worry about the length at all. Normally, lengths on coats are really long and I have to wear heels with it. This I actually feel pretty comfortable wearing, you know, flatter shoes and not having to feel like I need to add height to actually make this look good. All right, so this one I absolutely love. Let's move on to the next outfit. All right guys, so here is my next outfit. I have the Italian wool cashmere blend sweater on right now. And then for my pants, I have the mid-rise skinny Sloan pants. And I actually like both these a lot. I love this sweater. This sweater is actually technically called a crop sweater. I don't know why it's called a crop sweater, because as you guys can see, it is not cropped whatsoever, but it actually falls at a really, really nice length. I absolutely love where this falls. I like that I can wear this untucked and it still looks very like put together. It still looks very fitted and just really cute. So I love the length of where the sweater falls. For it being a wool blend sweater, this is actually not that itchy. There's a little bit of itch, like not as comfortable as the first sweater I tried on, but it's still very, very comfortable and it's so soft and it just feels really, really nice on. I don't know, I just think that this has a really nice, elegant look to it without it being super like thick and heavy. So I really like just the feel of this. I like just how easy this is to wear, because I honestly think you can wear this with absolutely anything. The fit is perfect. The length of the sleeve is perfect on me. I honestly can't say enough good things about this sweater. So I ordered this in an extra small and the color is sand beige, in case you're interested in it as well. And yeah, just really love this. Tucked in, this looks really cute as well. The only thing I will say about tucking this particular sweater in is there is a very thick, kind of like stretchy material on the bottom here, and it's just like the way that it's knit. Because of this kind of thick area, it's very straight. So when you do tuck it in, because of that kind of band on the bottom, it like is just straight, so it doesn't flop over like other sweaters. So if you like that kind of flopped over look, this one is a little bit tricky. You can definitely get it, but like sometimes I'll like flip back up and then it just kind of looks really awkward. So this one, I feel like it's better untucked than it is tucked, but still very cute. It still works, but just kind of something to consider. That's one thing that I noticed at least. Moving on to the pants, these are the mid-rise skinny Sloan pants. So it does go a little bit lower than the first pair of pants I tried. And honestly, if you like mid-rise pants, these are beautiful. I'm actually right now just kind of leaning more towards the high-rise pants. I don't know why, I just think they're really comfortable. They just fit a lot better in my opinion, but this is still really nice if you don't mind the mid-rise, or if you prefer the mid-rise. I just think that this is where it hits my love handles, and so it kind of just makes me feel, just doesn't feel as comfortable on me. Length is still very good. I like that this doesn't have the zipper on the bottom, so you can roll these up just fine. I actually really, really like the material of these pants. I kind of want to go and see if they have a high-rise version of these pants because I love the fit. Everything is like perfect. I just don't like the rise on the pants. Very flattering and super comfortable. So one thing I like about Banana Republic is the quality is actually very good. I used to get a lot of stuff from my mom from Banana Republic because she would shop there and she's really good at finding deals. And so she would go find these deals from Banana Republic, and I honestly would have their clothes for so long. Like, I have a sweater now that I still wear that is probably like 10 years old and it still looks like brand new. So I really like Banana Republic. I don't know why I stopped shopping with them. I think it's just because it's one of those stores that I thought I had to go to the store and I forgot that they have an online shop. But now that I've kind of opened those doors again, I'm definitely gonna be shopping there more. One thing that I've noticed so far out of the clothes that I have tried on so far is just the quality has been phenomenal and the fit has been like really, really nice. And then so with this outfit, I actually paired it with this beautiful, beautiful trench coat. I've been wanting a trench coat for so long. My mom gave me a trench coat when I was younger, but it was like really long on me. So I've been looking for a trench coat ever since. And one thing I've noticed is every single trench coat that I've liked has been over my budget. And then all the ones that were in my budget were like super long. And this is the first time I was able to find a trench coat that not only do I like, but I also think fits really well. I think it is so cute. It's lined really well. It's not super heavy and it cuts off right above the knees for me, which is really nice. And I think one of the reasons why this coat fits so well is because it is petite, extra small, and it's just so flattering. And I love this. It's honestly, to me, it feels like it's a coat that looks like it's hundreds of dollars. And I can't believe that I was able to get this for like under $60. How amazing is that? I was actually planning on saving for a Burberry trench coat, but now having found this, I don't think I need that anymore because this is just, this checks all the box for me. And it's beautiful, it's timeless, and I know Banana Republic clothes that I've had in the past have all been really good quality, so I'll probably have this for years and years to come. All right, so here are the next two items. For the top, I have the chunky cable knit sweater in ivory white. It is an extra small. It's actually very similar to this chunky cable knit sweater. The only difference is this is a petite and this is not a petite. And I can definitely tell the difference between the two sizing. I definitely like the petite fit a lot better on my body. This just seems a little bit looser. It's harder to tuck in. The sleeves are a little bit longer. So overall fit, this doesn't fit as well as this one. This one fits phenomenally well. So as I mentioned, this one is a little bit harder to tuck in. You can definitely see a little bit of bulging in these pants. I'll go ahead and untuck this for you guys so you can see how this one kind of flows out a little bit. It's not as flattering on the body. This also has that kind of high-low fit on the bottom here. And with it not being a petite, I like it even less. I just feel like it's just not super flattering. It just doesn't look good on my body. I wish this was a little bit shorter. I wish it was a little bit tighter here so that I can actually tuck this in a little bit better if I want to. Even wearing it loose like this, untucked, I don't think it looks very flattering, whereas the other one, wearing it untucked was fine. I think that's kind of the difference between a petite sizing and regular sizing, so it's actually really nice to see the difference between Banana Republic's two options that you can get. All right, so let's move on to the bottoms. Now these are the high-rise vegan suede leggings with pin tucks. These are actually pretty similar to the high-rise Sloan leggings. The only difference is, of course, the material. This is like a vegan suede, which actually feels pretty good when you just touch the material. Because it has this kind of pin or like the stitching on the front of it, I can definitely feel the stitching and it's not super comfortable. It's a little bit itchy. It's not as comfortable as the high-rise Sloan leggings. This also has a zipper on the bottom of the pants, and as I mentioned before, when you have the zipper on the bottom, it's just a lot harder to tailor. This actually fits me at a pretty good length. I don't think that I'd have to take this up, but it is a little bit loose on the bottom, especially with boots. That's kind of something to think about. If you want to wear a lot of boots, it's a little bit nicer to have the pants a little bit higher, but I feel like that's, you know, personal preference. Some people might like it longer, some people might like it shorter, so it just depends on your preference. But if you happen to be my height or somewhere around there, these pants do fit really well, so you don't have to worry about it being like super, super long. Because of the material, however, I noticed that this is a little bit more difficult to tuck sweaters in than the Sloan legging. This Sloan legging material is a little bit thicker, so it's more forgiving. Whereas this one, you can definitely tell there's material tucked into the pants, there's more bulging, there's more like bulkiness that can be seen. So that's something to think about also if you want to wear these pants with sweaters and with shirts tucked in. But other than that though, I think it is pretty flattering. The material itself is very comfortable once you get past that kind of itchiness of the stitching. But yeah, I mean, they're not my favorite pair of pants. If you like that kind of suede material for that texture, then these are really nice. For me, honestly, I can't really tell a huge difference between these and the Sloan leggings. And I prefer the Sloan leggings a little bit better just because I have the option to tuck things in without it being super bulky. Okay, so this is the Double Face Cocoon Coat in light gray. It's an extra small. This is not petite. However, I feel like this fits pretty well, even though it's not a petite. You can definitely tell the arms or the sleeves are a little bit longer on me, which is not a huge deal. I think this material is very easy to get altered and tailored, but what I really like about this is the length. I think the length of this coat falls really well where on my body. It's just under the knee, which I really, really like because it gives that kind of longer coat look without it feeling like it's swallowing me. It also has some really large collars, and at first I didn't really know if I liked that or not. I thought that it was way too big, way too like kind of floppy, but it's definitely growing on me and I do like it. And what I also like is you can button this up like this, and it actually looks really cute buttoned up. There are no other buttons, so you don't have to worry about messing with all those other buttons. There's no belt or anything, so I think this look in itself is like actually pretty cute, kind of a more unique style, which makes this a little bit more of a versatile coat. Now, as I mentioned, there are no buttons, so you can't really, you know, secure it in place. It's more of a coat that you just kind of throw on, so I feel like that makes it not ideal for really, really cold weather. I think this is nice for milder temperatures so that you don't have to worry about keeping it closed when you're outside and like freezing. And then lastly with this coat, I absolutely love the color. I think that this light gray color is just gorgeous. I think it is just so pretty. I like this a lot on my body. This one also doesn't have the lining on the inside. None of the coats that I got has a lining on the side, which on the inside, which I'm actually very surprised by considering the price point. I think this is also originally $150. For that price, I just wish there was a liner because I just feel like having a liner just makes a coat feel a little bit more premium, a little upscale, a little bit more better made. It also flows really well. So it just lays on the body really well, and I like that a lot. I think that it is a really good coat for, you know, spring, fall, even mild winter weather like we have here in Texas. So overall, I think this is like one of my favorite items from this haul. I think it's super cute and it's very, very wearable, and I'm really, really excited to incorporate this into more outfits. Okay, so there are only two pieces left in this haul and they are both coats. So the first one is this one right here. This is the Unlined Double Face Top Coat in charcoal gray. This one is pretty much identical to this coat, except this one is just in dark camel. So because this one is the same coat as this one, as I mentioned, it has a looser fit. It's more of a straight fit than a fitted fit. So, you know, it's very flowy, it's very loose, and that's very much in style right now with where the trend is going, which I actually really like. I like that it's not super fitted, it's more comfortable to wear. Originally, I thought that I liked this type of collar a little bit more. I feel like I like this collar a little bit better. This one is nice, it just seems like it's a little bit too like original. You know, there's nothing really special about it. I do like that this has the buttons. So if you are in a cooler climate, you can definitely just button this up and not have to worry about keeping your coat you know, on your body when it's super cold outside, so you're not like freezing. As you can see, even with this button, it is a very loose fit, very like, you know, just straight on the side. And because this isn't a petite fit, you can definitely tell the sleeves are a little bit longer on me, but I feel like that it's a pretty easy fix if you really don't like that. So you can definitely get that fixed fairly easily. But yeah, so this coat I do like a lot. I like the color. I think that dark gray is just a nice coat to have because it's still kind of more of a neutral palette, a neutral color, but it's still so different from the other coats we've seen here. So overall, I do like this a lot. I like the fit, I like the flow. Again, this is not lined. Same price tag as the other two coats here, but you can't really tell when you're wearing it. It's not like this flies open. It flows, it fits the body really well, so I do like that a lot. Okay, so let's move on to the very last coat in this haul, which is this cocoon coatigan sweater. So as you guys can tell by the name, this is kind of like a mix between a coat and a cardigan. And I don't know, like I was very hesitant about this because I thought it was kind of a weird like mix. I thought it was gonna be more of like a knit material like these two, but it definitely isn't. It's a very sturdy, very like thick knit material, which is nice. I actually really like this. I like that it isn't so formal. I like that this has a more casual, like laid back feel to it, although it kind of has that same feeling as like a nice coat. This falls right above the knee for me. I feel like it fits really well because of that material, because it's like a thick knit material rather than like a wool. I like that this is right in between structure and like flowy, comfortable. So you're kind of getting the best of both worlds with this coatigan. This is not a petite, this is an extra small. The shoulder here fits pretty well on me, and then the sleeves actually fit well. It's not like super long or anything like that, so I do like this a lot. This is kind of the surprise of the haul, but I'm glad that I got this because this is very comfortable. I do like this. All right, so that is pretty much it for this haul. I hope you guys found this video helpful. I hope that this gives you a better idea of how Banana Republic clothes fit and helps you shop for your clothes online as well. So yeah, let me know your thoughts and opinions in the comment section below. Do you guys have a favorite piece from this haul, or do you guys have a favorite piece that you have from Banana Republic? I would love to know all that in the comment section below. Please give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and if you haven't done so already, be sure to click on that subscribe button right there and hit that bell notification so you can see more videos like this. I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!